Hello and welcome to a new World War Z video. My name is Rainier Triple8 and today I will start a guide of how you can complete each level in the game in extreme difficulty solo with only using the bots. The first episode begins from the first stage of New York Descent and we will explore all the strategies and the classes that we can use to help you complete the level easier. Please keep in mind that this guide is based on my personal experience, and there are always different ways and classes that you can use for each level. If you are already experienced with a level, feel free to leave your personal notes in the comment section below, so we can all help our fellow survivors. Firstly, this guide will focus on completing all the levels without using any mutators, so that you can unlock all the achievements such as the sniper and the katana, if you haven't already done it. The second thing we will discuss is the classes and specs. My personal recommendation for this level are the Hellraiser and the Exterminator, with the Hellraiser being my first option. The simple reason is their access to claymore mines, that helps us in the first two swarm attacks. With our current spec, the Hellraiser is excellent at killing boots very easily and very fast. You will find the details for each spec at the end of the video, and I will prepare a separate video that explains why I use each talent for each of the different classes. There's too many. Get to the elevator. The first part of the stage is as usual a stealth mission. Just make sure you avoid doing any loud noises, make sure your primary weapon is fully upgraded and have a silencer, and avoid using any heavy weapons or equipment. This way you will only have to deal with the hateful creepers slash lurkers, and make sure you kill every one of them that you find. And just make sure to sweep all the stages to find your medkit and equipment bag, and you can go to the next level of the stage fully prepared. I hit the button. The only thing you need to be aware of in the end of the first part is that as soon as you arrive in the elevator, a bull may be inside, so make sure to have your grenade launcher ready, and you will only need two shots to finish him off very easily. After the elevator, we will head down to prepare for the first swarm attack, and here we will demonstrate why we need the claymores and how we can utilize them. For the tactic to work, you will need a minimum of 8 claymores, meaning 2 supply bags. Firstly, make sure to finish off all the roaming Zeke around the area, as across the hall here or upstairs, because if they trigger any claymore or make any noise, the Zeke from downstairs will aggro and you will not have the time to prepare for the wave. We will place the claymores in two key locations, here in the other side. In this way we will make sure that the Zeke that will spawn from here we will not flank us, and we will only have to worry for the Zeke that will tower in front of us. The reason we place the claymore facing away from the direction of the Zeke will be coming from is to make sure that they will be triggered by the first Zeke that will pass them instead of the first Zeke that will reach them. This tactic will make sure that you can overall kill more Zeke using your claymores. This is the next location we will need to place the claymore mines, so the Zeke will not be able to flank us. In case you are lucky like me and have more claymores available, there are more spawn locations you can place them. Just make sure to save 4 for the last wave. These are the next spawn locations you can place your claymores in order to help you further with the Zeke. It's optional as I said, but it will definitely make a difference in case you have any extra claymores. After you place the last landmines, just make sure to check the area around for the extra heavy weapons available and start the swarm attack. You can shoot the giant glass stars in the ceiling, immediately change to your heavy weapon and focus on the pyramid in front of you. As you can see, we won't have many Zeke coming from our flanks. Thanks to the claymore and the bots, which gives us all the time we need to focus on the primary primate from downstairs. Just make sure to check the flank for any incoming bulls, as the claymores are not enough to finish them off, and in this case you will need to change to your grenade launcher and finish them off yourself. Once the wave is over, we resupply, we get the claymores and the heavy weapon we have saved upstairs usually, and we head back to prepare for the next wave. After you pass the stairs, you will have a limited time to set up your defenses and claymores, so make sure to check all your available gear upstairs beforehand. A little tip in case you find a crate: if your team is in high health and you already carry a medkit and heavy weapon, by placing one claymore mine will give you a very high chance to spawn supply bugs that can help you with your defense. Your priority is to place at least one claymore on top of its stairs and then downstairs, as you can see here, as they are both major spawn points for your flank. Secondary options are the stairs, and then if you still have more claymores available, you can place them in front of the fence where the swarm will attack. As for the defenses, make sure to place any barbed wires and vaulted grids on the same side, which will make a perfect defense point. Auto turrets should be facing towards the place you find harder to defend. Personally, I face them forward along with the other defenses to give me 10 to deal with any special Zeke from the back.
Big gun set. Got some defenses.
Make sure you have the time to use everything available and take your position to prepare for the swarm attack. Prioritize using the heavy machine gun if available, and then rely on your heavy weapons to thin out the first wave of the swarm. Although the claymores will help a lot, they are not as effective as against the first swarm attack, so make sure after the first half of the swarm to check your flank in case you get attacked by any special zombies or if you have any Zeke roaming around. Make sure you have ammo available for your grenade launcher, and once the bulls will spawn from behind, fastly dispose of them. You usually can expect between 2 to 4 bulls to spawn here, depending on your luck. You can use the rest of your grenade launcher in case you need help dealing with the rest of the swarm. Since there weren't too many Zeke left from the swarm, I chose not to go and resupply my grenade launcher and use my primary weapon to finish the rest off. In case a bull spawns and you do not have any grenades available, make sure it charges a bot and take the opportunity to finish him off using your primary weapons or melee. After the swarm has ended, go resupply, take a heavy weapon, preferably one that has explosives, payload, rifle, or MG are the top priorities, claymore mines are not necessary, but if you have you can carry them, and proceed to the final part of the mission. Another tip for soloing: if your bots are very low health, there are certain spawn points as here, and if you finish them off, it will spawn with more than almost half health after that, so make sure to finish the bot off before you go to the spawn point, and that will help you with having bots with higher health. You now arrive at the last part of the mission that can be the hardest to deal with. Unfortunately, the tactic I found the easiest and safest is the most time consuming, but has a very high success rate. This hall is sort of a safe area and the Zeke will be coming only from our front. We will use this to our advantage along with our bot's infinite ammo supplies. Let's start with the steps. After you arrive at the train and talk to the driver, you will have to immediately run to the first door on the left to get your first supply crate. Once you are inside, turn left again, take any gear crates first if available, and then pick up the supply crate. After that, run straight to the safe hallway and make sure you stay approximately in the middle. Here we will demonstrate how the bots will be able to help you dealing with almost all the Zeke without any of your help. This is a very nice spot to stay and wait for the Zeke to come to you. Make sure you save as much ammo as possible and leave the heavy lifting to the bots. Finish any of the Zeke that may come close and make sure you prioritize any bulls that may be among them. If a second wave spawns, as you can see here, and the bots only have the pistols, just take your distance and make sure your bots have enough space to finish off the Zeke. As you saw here, the bots were almost more than enough to finish most of the Zeke. They just needed some assistance for some roaming Zeke with melee attacks and the minimum amount of bullets, and that's what you will be doing from now on from the next 7 crates. After all the Zeke are dead, we just return the crate to the train, resupply for our ammo, and go back again to the safe place, not to the next crate, we just run again to the safe place. And we will wait to see if any more Zeke will spawn, so we can have an easier time going to the next crate. Sometimes the Zeke may not spawn from here, you just need to wait a couple of seconds and make sure that none of the Zeke will spawn, but as you can see here, the Zeke have respawned again and I leave the heavy lifting to the bots again, going a little further back since they have the pistols, and follow the same rules, minimum amount of bullets, and leave the rest to the bots. From now on, you just repeat the steps. Firstly, you pick up a supply crate and run back to the safe place. Secondly, you finished all the roaming Zeke and return the supply crate to the train. Third, you run back to the safe place and wait to see if any Zeke will spawn. And fourth, if they spawn, you finish them off or you just continue with your steps. This may take a lot of time compared to other strategies, but it's the safest way to avoid any unpleasant surprises. Some final tips during the process is to be careful for the spawning lurkers when you run to the supply crates. And finally, the door order I used to open for the supply crates, you will find it on the video, but I will also clarify one by one. We will begin with the first bottom left door, second we go to the top left door, the first top left, then the second top left, and the final door we will leave, it's the bottom left, the second one. Sometimes one of these doors may not be able to open, so you have to go to the only door on the right on the bottom and leave it for last. I will leave the rest of the video without any additional comments so you can have a look at the rest of the run. I really hope this video will help you with your strategies, and please leave any suggestions you may have to the comment section below. Stay tuned for more World War Z guides, thank you very much for watching, and I really hope you have a great day!
Those giants! in the Bronx must be shitting in their drawers by now.
We gotta shut him up. Got another one. Fucker better drive. Stay quiet. Here.
Oh, you guys are the best.
We got a creeper close by.
Infector's gonna
hawk
one!
Sneaky.
Gas bag gone. Watch for the cloud.
There's more where that came
from. Loading ammo!
So, what happens, right, when the armored grunts turn armored Zeke?
Found a box. Bringing it back to the train. Gotta be quiet here. Here.
Oh, you guys are the best.
We got a creeper close by.
So everybody's going north for the big freeze, huh? Smart. Until the big thaw.
Creeper down. Found a box. Bringing it back to the train.
Those giants in the Bronx must be shitting in their drawers by now.
Creeper is close.
When are we gonna leave?
To work today is to eat tomorrow. Bring more.
Whack job.
Reloading!
Show's over. Screamer down.
Spotted a hazmat.
Look out for the wall!
Gas back there. Watch these people.
Bolt's finally down. Found a box. Bringing it back to the train.
Americans, man! Lost every sea! What now? Bigger guns!
Here.
Oh, you guys are the best.
Found a box. Bringing it back to the train. When are we gonna leave?
All aboard! Who's coming aboard?
Oh, we're making too much noise! They're gonna come!
We gotta go now!
Do you wanna try?
They're gonna break the doors!
Now hold!
Jaws that bite and claws that catch! Oh, beware the Jabberwock, my son!
Crazy son of a bitch. Crazy son.